We have worked for several years transforming biomass into fuels and chemicals. We have developed catalysts that are active, selective, recyclable, stable, and inexpensive. But to date, we have focused mostly on renewable diesel. This project will allow us to adapt this technology for the production of sustainable aviation fuel, which is a more complex and thus challenging fuel, but also very important since it is much more difficult to electrify an aircraft than it is an on-road vehicle.
So the R&D project, the underlying big point here is to try to produce a fuel for aviation. It's essentially indistinguishable from the fossil-derived fuels that are already in use. So the waste lipids are going to constitute the bulk of the fuel. And those waste lipids come from places like a sewage or restaurants, or this is essentially like fats and greases and oils. A lot of the biofuels that are currently available have some issues, specifically that a lot of that stuff contains oxygen. Those molecules that have oxygen in them give a lot of undesirable properties to the fuel. One of the goals is to remove that oxygen. The feedstock that we'll have to use to help this have the properties that jet fuel needs is a substance called rosin. Rosin is another product that's produced by the timber industry. The molecules in that rosin, once we remove the oxygen from those molecules, that is going to give us a fuel with the properties that jet fuel requires. And the way that we're going to do that is with something called a catalyst. A catalyst is a substance or a material that reduces the energy required for a chemical reaction. We are going to apply heat and pressure in the presence of the catalyst, and then that will allow us to get fossil-like fuels in a matter of hours instead of millions of years. These reactions are already done industrially in a lot of places, but the catalysts that are currently in use are problematic. They usually use a precious metal, such as platinum or palladium, and platinum and palladium are extremely expensive. So one of the goals of this project is to make this process more financially sensible by using metals that are much cheaper, such as nickel, iron, and copper. Big advantage of these feeds is that they are what's called geographically distributed. Essentially, they're everywhere. What that allows us to do is have smaller reaction systems that can be deployed in lots of places that can be built more cheaply, and also saves huge energy costs in terms of shipping.
My role is basically the day-to-day activities. I started off by the catalyst preparation and also the feedstock preparation as well. What the reactor does is basically when you have your catalyst prepared, you feed these catalysts, you reduce and feed these catalysts into the reactor, and also you add your feedstock to the reactor. So we have it continuously fed, and then we get our liquid products at the end. We try to analyze the products obtained from the reactor, actually simulate the distillation process itself, where we actually get products from the syndes at different boiling points. For me, I actually enjoy the fact that I'm getting a lot of experience, apart from my degree, extending towards my doctorate degree. I'm really humbled working alongside with a lot of great people, Dr. Eduardo, Dr. Robbie, and other graduate students here. It's really humbling and a wonderful experience.
One of the big problems that we face as scientists is actually getting the money to do our work. Where R&D is really different is that they are more interested in funding fundamental science. They want to give people the money to come up with new ideas, essentially, instead of funding work that has already started. We need that fundamental science. We need to get those ideas. We need to flesh them out more thoroughly than we're able to just without any funding opportunity at all. R&D is like a breath of fresh air. They want to see the work get done. They're less concerned about red tape. They're less concerned about the bureaucracy.
The ease with which we're working with R&D has been both surprising and refreshing. They told me things. I still have that email. No worries at all. You can get started whenever it's most convenient. And I had to do a double take because I'm really not used to that. I really appreciate the opportunity that we were given. It's an honor and a privilege, but also the relationship that we have with them as a funding agency has already profiled to be a pretty pleasant and productive one.